Dykes in Film: The Image of Lesbians in Mainstream Entertainment. Plays and independent films seem to dare more to approach the diversity of reality. But have you ever noticed what happens to the image of lesbians in mainstream film and television? For a long time, it used to be that the only image you were likely to see was that of the overbearing, mean, man-hating lesbian who had probably served time at some point. Her appearance was deliberately made to contrast with that of the acceptable Hollywood face and body, so that she would not look as though she could fit in with all the so-called beautiful people to whom she was a nemesis. She was often used to portray the iconic female gym teacher. The message intended for public consumption was something like, lesbians are ugly and a threat to the masculinity of men, the purity and goodness of women and femininity, the innocence of our young people, law and order, and generally all we consider decent and normal in our society. We've come a long way since then. But there's still something funny going on. These days, what you usually find is that a woman can be a lesbian as long as she's appropriately feminine, or she can be tough and even boyish as long as she's proven to be heterosexual, or at least bisexual. The usual exception is when a woman who's supposed to be butch unintentionally comes off as a femme in men's clothes, trying a little too hard to make a big show of saying, "Look how butch I am." Whatever. The problem seems to come mainly from two sources. One is that lesbian characters in mainstream entertainment are usually portrayed by straight women, while the lesbian actors are left to play straight characters. The closet is only partly to blame for this, and not the whole story. A little more about that later. In any case, commonly casting straight actors for gay roles does produce kind of an odd minstrel effect, as we're always being interpreted by others rather than allowed to genuinely represent ourselves. Yes, that's what acting is about. No, you can't expect an actor to have experienced everything that a character has, but a character can't be well portrayed by an actor who doesn't get it. There's such a big push to prove that we don't all fit the stereotypes that nobody is allowed to be presented in a realistic way that might display something a stereotype is actually based on. That's the trouble when you can't tell the difference between an image created by someone's ignorant assumptions and the simple facts of a real person's existence. No, lesbians are not all alike. No, we're not trying to be men. But some of us really are butch, and that doesn't make us horrible people. And on a side note, female-to-male transsexuals aren't trying to be men either. They are men. So why aren't more lesbians making a fuss about all this? That's the other part of the problem. Once upon a time, at least in some parts of the country, the lesbian community itself didn't know how to approach things any differently than to divide everybody up into separate camps of butch and femme. That's how everybody related, because the larger society didn't allow a better model for heterosexuals, and gays weren't organized and connected enough yet to come up with something better. But Stonewall and the feminist movement changed all that. As the gay rights and feminist movements grew, so did lesbian consciousness about what was possible both for an individual and within a relationship. The downside was the resulting backlash against identifying as butch or femme at all. After a decade or so, however, a new awareness began to emerge, as people began to understand the many ways in which any person could express being a man or a woman. Many lesbians became more open again about identifying as butch or femme. This was not a knock against the androgyny so true to the being of large numbers of lesbians everywhere. It was just an acknowledgement that androgyny is not true to everybody. And in this newly emerging openness and honesty, there came to be an understanding, at least for some, that there were as many ways for a lesbian to be butch or femme as there were for heterosexuals to be masculine or feminine. But not everybody was hip to this idea. To some it meant a trip back to the bad old days, when not allowing yourself to be stuffed into one box or the other meant not being trusted and accepted by your own people. It represented being trapped in outmoded gender roles. Many women felt a great sense of freedom when they were released from this limiting requirement, and they couldn't understand what they thought of as a willing return to such an imprisoning way of life. Perhaps they feared that if such identities became popular again, everybody would end up being forced into them, just as they felt they had been before. It didn't occur to them that having to deny yourself in order to fit the androgynous model can be just as oppressive. For others, the issue was homophobia. Their approach to combating it was to prove that homosexuals are just exactly like heterosexuals, except for who we sleep with. A thing to downplay, because nobody really wants to know what you do in bed anyway. Never mind the fact that being aware someone is straight doesn't mean you know what kind of activities they engage in during sex, or even whether or not they have sex at all. Even if a couple has children, you can't really swear that you know. Not in this modern age of technology. Anyway, the appearance of clearly identifiable butches and femmes anywhere from pride parades to films and TV to everyday workplaces and around the neighborhood represents an obvious threat to the efforts of those who want to prove we're just like straight people, especially if you like to forget that straights come in all varieties too. The common refrain from this facet of our community, from men and women alike, towards men and women alike, seems to be, "You're the reason straight people hate us." As if the idea of a really macho guy getting it up the butt would make a straight guy feel any more comfortable with gay men. Or as if a man would feel any less hurt to his pride if the woman rejecting him for another woman were petite, pretty, and girly, just to give two examples. Actually, the fact is that those of us who can't help standing out if we're to be true to ourselves at all are the ones that force society to reckon with the existence of gay men and lesbians. Otherwise, we could be quietly denied our rights until it suited the powers that be to do a little demonstration and slap us down from time to time, just to make sure we know our place and stay in it. Besides, if you think we look freaky to the rest of the world, just remember that such a degree of contrast for us is what makes those of you who can pass look so normal. In other words, we're why people are so much less upset by you. So it would be nice if you didn't piss on our heads while you're standing on our shoulders. So who does the current state of affairs ultimately serve? It's not hard to guess. First and foremost, it serves homophobes, especially those men who like the idea that they're such great gifts to womankind that they could ultimately have any woman they chose. If a woman seems butch but is proven to be straight, she's seen as potentially vulnerable to a man's charm. If she's a lesbian but cute and feminine enough, a guy can believe she's not really as gay as she claims, because how could someone so attractive really ultimately deny any feelings for men? In such a man's mind, God wouldn't allow such a tragic waste to occur. And if nothing else, when the person playing the role is straight, men everywhere can be satisfied that even if the character says no to men, when the acting is all over, the real woman behind the character says yes. Phew! Dodged a bullet there, huh? There's nothing to do about all this except to let all people be themselves and to promote authenticity everywhere. If you're making a film or a television show, you're not doing something radical by presenting yet another woman who's disconnected from her own culture, kind of androgynous but with a nod to feminine convention, and largely indistinguishable from all the other characters of that kind out there. Women who style themselves that way do exist, and they deserve to get their due, but they're not all of us. And the worst of this is not just that they're usually the only ones to be seen, but that the creators of these characters keep claiming that they do it this way in order to show the world a different view. Doing the same old thing, after it's already been done over and over again, is not doing something different.